Guys, this just in, Cyberpunk Edgerunners on Netflix, and this show is...
You guys are watching Layman's Review, and this is the review for Cyberpunk Edgerunners. It came out today, actually, as of recording.
Yesterday,
excuse me. And we're both finished, and oh my God.
Yeah.
This is like a nonstop roller coaster of just like adrenaline and violence, gore, nudity, sex. I'm Mr. TVMA, and this is TVMA approved.
I'm Mr. Nudity MA.
Oh, we're not going to get any spoilers in this review.
Try not to.
We just recently did a preview of the show from a trailer.
Right.
It's above Ryan's head if you haven't seen that yet. And you went into this completely blind, had no idea what was going on.
I don't even know what the game was about. After we watched the trailer, I didn't even know what the game was about to leave, even walk into this show. I was like, okay, you've steered me wrong. And you know what this show reminded me of between the music, a little bit of the story and all that kind of like, well, like the spontaneity, I think that's the word, of the story.
What?
Dora Hedoro, and I was ready to turn this motherfucker off.
Oh my God.
I was like, this again? Netflix is delivering me hot garbage. And Ryan set me up for failure, and I didn't know how to take this. But anyway, I did manage to struggle through every 10 episodes of that.
Wow. Okay. So couldn't disagree, obviously, anymore. Everything from the show, from the music, which was, my God, it was on point. Every episode, every scene just had like this underlying orchestral, depending on what the scene was, it was just bonkers to off the wall, or it was going to be like something like low-lying and melodic while it was going through one of its scenes. The action sequences were just out of this world. The animation was just incredible in every scene. The way they animated brutality was just amazing to me.
I'm just sitting here listening. I'm ready. I'm ready when I'm ready.
And I like the love interest. I usually am like anti romance in like my shows I watch.
He did mention the love interest, in
but like, I was like interested into David and Lucy's relationship.
Mm-hmm. Yet another predatory thing because she's well over
17. I love the societal
realism of how, what we're moving towards.
You know, in the very beginning of the first episode, it paints a very good picture of what society looks like when we're at the point where these cybernetic augmentations are the way of the world, and everything costs money, and you know, a lot of Night City, which is where the show's set in, everyone's poor, everything costs money. It kind of like how we are now, how we're getting to, you know, you're going to have to pay every time you blink somebody's fee.
You get a charge like a taxi fare.
I was so here for this show. It killed my expectations, blew them away.
Let me stop being a hater. This show is absolutely amazing.
Oh, okay.
The art style, loved it. This is the first show I legitimately went after.
Okay, I thought you were giving me, like, I thought you set this up at the end of 10 episodes, you were done.
No, so okay. This was the first show that I shit you not. I was like, okay, I need to see if they have a soundtrack for this.
Oh, thank God. I thought we were going to disagree.
It was fantastic. I think the story was cool. I think it is a glimpse into our future.
It is, yeah.
I think I watched it dubbed. This is dubbed, it was good. They had Juan Carlos
Esposito. I went back and forth between them, and the dub was not as good as the sub, but I could tolerate it.
No, it was, so. I honestly, and not knowing anything about the show and or the game or anything of the direction of what this should have been, I'm like, I got right into this really quick.
Okay, yeah, and I was almost convinced you were going to say I absolutely hate it, because it's sci-fi, you're not into the futuristic. You're not into like that sort of thing. You're much more skewed to fantasy. So I knew this was going to be like a left wing thing.
I want another field. Season. No spoilers. I'm torn if they could carry it on or not.
Is this canon, by the way? So
is it?
We found out that this show is canon to the Cyberpunk universe.
Now I know I wouldn't like the game just because I'm not a big gamer like that. Like that's like to
He's
me.
He's a World of Warcraft.
Yeah, that's it. Strictly. Yeah,
very niche thing.
I don't know. Like you were about to go into some negatives. It'd be hard. Like I'd be like surface level negatives.
I do have a few. I mean, I have a few. I thought the story. I felt like they were trying to tell a very big story in 10 episodes, and it could have been 12 or 15 episodes.
I'm so used to that by now that seems to be the common place for
sure. Well, that was an issue. It was a little jarring for me, episode to episode, where they were trying to tell you so much so fast.
We had a time jump.
It was almost like, hey, sit down, yep, buckle up, pay attention, or otherwise you're going to be lost. 25
minutes. You got so much in a 25-minute episode. Yeah. And there were, I can't agree with you more about, there was so much more that happened behind the scenes that... Mm-hmm. We just were meant to assume. Now, I don't know if that was story that we would know if we knew the story, but like things were going on. I'm like, I don't know. The doctor was fantastic.
Yeah.
I think David played a good character. I think
I did too.
You know, his mother, you know, they did him. He's on the poor side. You know, she wanted the best for him. And, you know, I think that whole group.
That was another thing in the very first episode where they were trying to sell you on the relationship between David and his mom.
Right.
Gloria. And what she had said. And it kind of like, it did. I wish I had a little bit more time to like see them together.
Like to build that like depression.
Exactly.
Yes.
To where like when later things happen, you feel a little bit more weight behind them.
Right.
So that was something I would have liked. And that's where I was saying if it was a longer runtime, we could have had this.
Let's say 45 minutes, 10 episodes. Yeah. Or 15 episodes, 16 episodes, we would have got a little bit the same thing. But I think, you know, it painted the picture of, like you said, like, you pay for everything. They had levels of insurance, what hospital you went to. Like, things that we can scarily see happening now.
One of the things was anytime you would die as a person in Night City, it was like, what kind of death plan do you have? And, like, depending on how high of a tier, like gold and platinum, you would have, like, immediate, like...
Within 5 minutes, they're there.
Like a pickup of your body and it be disposed of in a way that you would like.
Or they leave your ass.
Who gives a shit when I'm gone?
No,
you know?
I thought like everything about this show, and not to drag this on because I could dive into this show because there's so many things that were neat
about
it.
So many things.
But I definitely, you know, if this could be a potential discussion show, let us know, because I think
like a deep dive
because there was a lot in that, you know, those 10 episodes.
So I will say that CD Projekt Red, the creators of Cyberpunk the game anyway, Mike Pondsmith was the one who actually created Cyberpunk the universe.
Okay.
They used that to create Cyberpunk the game. It has got me so interested. I've been waiting. I have a PS5 and I was waiting for the next gen update that came out, and then patch 1.16 just dropped.
Okay,
and apparently it fixed more stuff. I am definitely going to download this game and I'm going to play it now because I just want more.
I got Arcane-y vibes from this.
I'm so glad you brought that up.
Definitely, even between Becca, who that little character,
my favorite character,
Jinx.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, this is wild, bitch.
Jinx, who actually,
now obviously Arcane to me, like it'll hopefully be above my head. I had more building and more depth.
Yeah.
Where this, I think, is just, I don't know why all of a sudden they decided to make this, because the game, to my knowledge, and this is outside looking in, did not go well.
It was only because it was broken, not because the story was something that no one liked.
So they have a good story.
I want to play it, but it's broken.
Gotcha.
That was the problem. Not, well, this game sucks.
And I just hope the fans come to this, though, because without that bad taste in their mouth from the game, I really hope they give this show a shot.
I really wish we could have all reset our brains and then, like, reviewed the game today. Like, because a lot of people, you're right, have like a negative connotation when it comes to Cyberpunk, because it's like, oh, you mean the game that was like an utter disaster when it dropped? It was like, man, it hurts my heart, because CD is like my favorite developer and I wanted them to do better at launch. But I think that if we reviewed the game now, it would get much better scores across the board.
So we can come back and if you get the game in the meanwhile, we'll do the discussion and see, you can help me link it together a little bit. Yep. And I don't know any better time but to go into layman's review.
Let's go. All right, on three. One, two, three. It was everything I wanted it to be and more. Mm. I didn't know it could have been this. Now, I was trying to weigh, like, is it better than Arcane? And I'll say no.
Right.
I liked Arcane more.
That's it.
But for the things this show pulled off, the way, like, it had me on the edge of my seat the entire time, every storyline, every action scene, every sequence, the relationship between David and Lucy and the crew, the team building that they had, the way that they actually kind of cared for each other, I was sold. I can't tell you how excited I am for another season, if we get one, or if there's a continuation, just in the universe of Cyberpunk.
I hope it is something else.
This was like, it can't check a box more than it did for me.
Right.
And that's why I know that even though it's not better than Arcane to me, it deserves to be in that echelon of shows that just like absolutely knocked it out the park. Animation, music, storytelling, even though it was a little bit rushed. And I said, S's aren't perfect to me. To me, S's are something that, like, I go, I'm not forgetting that show for a very long time.
So, this is the question now I ask myself because Ryan invented this. Is it S-ish?
It is S-ish.
So, I look at it from that standpoint. Okay, so I wanted... So, the story was very jumpy.
It was.
It wasn't like panned out as well as I wanted it to be.
Yeah.
I think there was a lot of missing things. Did I absolutely fall in love with the characters? No, because yes, David was the focus, but we really didn't have a chance to grow with anybody else.
That is a good point.
You know what I mean? Like
Becca was as good as she was. Kiwi, she was kind
of Lucy and Becca and
Maine. Got a lot of Lucy.
Like you had you and didn't I love you didn't. Maine. Like Maine. She was too mysterious. We didn't dig into her things. So there was, and that I don't want to give it the show's fault. But more so, like, I guess probably Netflix only allowing them so much.
Sure.
Because obviously it'll cost more.
Yeah.
But I definitely, like, it's a high A. Like, if we did pluses, it would thoroughly get a plus because it didn't.
I'll meet you halfway. We'll put this at the top of A.
Oh, yeah. I think it passes One Punch Man.
And in order for this, so we'll give it an A. and it'll be at the top of A, and it'll be the benchmark to see if anything gets to an S.
This is the new, like, because the animation was different, but I liked it.
Yeah,
it
was like loud in your face, like
bright and colorful,
punching you in the mouth.
I just liked all these things, yeah. And like you know, the neon idea colors. Of like there are repercussions for what you do in this universe.
Cyberpsychosis.
Yeah, and I thought that was great. And then you have things I would say people, but things like Atom Smasher,
yeah.
Like those type of things that come through, and it's like okay, well that's
and
that's
I love the
thing.
Fact that the military grade pieces had like names.
Yep,
they were like they were like known. Like, ooh, oh, you have that augment.
Uh-huh.
Or, oh, I can't wait to, like, steal this military-grade piece.
Their school design, like, how learning is then in the future, that's how it will be.
Oh, my God, we didn't talk about this at all.
Mm-mm.
The phone conversations, how the bubbles
pop up on the
screen.
Oh, God, it's in your head, man.
And you just
you see it
the
in
words.
Your eye.
Yeah, Elon Musk somewhere is like, I'm working on that, trust me.
Yeah, him.
I'm working on it. Yeah, that Neuralink stuff, yeah, like,
but I definitely, like, it was right, it was almost at the S, and I feel like if they do another season and it hits as hard as this one, it is without a doubt going to be.
Okay, well, yeah, so A+.
I would give it an A+. It is the top of our A of this season. Even
you
looking
really
back
at
last
he
season.
He had me in the beginning.
Looking back at last season, it was
this
still
motherfucker
great.
Doesn't hate, like, he hates this show too. Man, we were about to argue hardcore.
Nope. No, I don't watch many shows in one day, but I watched this show in one day.
Okay, guys, that was Cyberpunk Edgerunners on Netflix. If you haven't watched it yet, we've been very careful not to do any spoilers. Go watch that show.
Please.
And then come back and let us know if you want us to do a discussion.
Yeah, please.
Let us know in the comments below what you thought about the season, and we will see you for the next episode of Layman's Review.